Hello and welcome to Epic Tutorials. My name's Elliot, and in this tutorial I'm going to teach you how to master srRAW for iPhone, the only app on iOS that unlocks RAW video recording. From capture through to post workflows using DaVinci Resolve, you'll learn everything you need to know in order to start experimenting with Cinema DNG RAW video on the iPhone. Please note this is a tutorial and not a recommendation or endorsement of the app. As you'll soon discover, srRAW's feature set is incredibly limited and the app is frustrating to use. So don't get this app thinking it is an alternative to Blackmagic Camera or Mavis. It is not. But it does deliver something incredibly powerful and unique, and the creator should be applauded. So if you're interested in RAW video on iPhone, I'd encourage you to support the developers, download the app, join the Cinema community, and share your feedback in the hope that the app will receive future updates with meaningful improvements, and you'll find it linked below. Now, let's head out into the field and learn how to capture RAW video on an iPhone. The first thing you want to do in srRAW is configure your capture settings. Tap the gear icon in the lower left corner. Start by selecting your lens. While ultra-wide and telephoto are available, they're both extremely noisy, so where possible, stick to the wide lens for the best results. Next, if you're planning to record clips longer than 1 minute, change record duration to free run. Next, choose your resolution. I'm using the Tarantino build, available only to Plus tier members of the Cinema community through test flight. It includes high resolution options like 3840x1388 on the 16 Pro Max, which is not available in the current App Store version. So for now, I'll select 3072x1728, which is the highest resolution 16:9 aspect ratio available on the iPhone 16 Pro. On the iPhone 15 Pro, the max supported resolution is 2560x1440. Note that srRAW currently only supports 24fps capture. You can't change the frame rate. Then tap Display Settings. Here you can enable a grid overlay, show audio levels, and choose your preferred timecode style. I prefer the styled option. As for General Settings menu, all options here are currently locked and not adjustable. Tap to close and return to the main camera UI. The srRAW interface is as minimal as it gets. On the left, you have access to your three settings panels, camera display and general settings. At the top, you'll see your current resolution, timecode and frame rate. On the right, you'll find buttons for focus and exposure modes, the record button, a shortcut to the srRAW folders under files, and the vertical VU meters for audio if enabled under settings. srRAW does not support tap to focus in the viewfinder, and there's no manual white balance either. We'll get into that in a moment. Tap the focus button and you'll see two modes, autofocus and manual focus. Autofocus behaves normally until you hit record, that is. The moment recording starts, focus locks. There's no continuous autofocus during capture, which is a serious limitation. Watch this. Before I hit record, srRAW automatically focuses on my chart. Once I start a recording and move the chart out of the frame, the focus doesn't adjust to the background, it just stays locked. To change focus mid-recording, you need to switch to manual focus, but the implementation is poor. Unlike a real camera or other camera apps where you get real-time feedback as you adjust focus, srRAW only updates the focus after you release the control, so it's basically guesswork. And to make things harder, srRAW's focus slider has only 10 stops between macro and infinity versus the 0 to 100 scale used in most other apps, which makes precision focusing near impossible. The only way to pull focus during recording semi-reliably is simply to practice your focus pull prior to recording. Note the values, and then hit them again during capture. For example, I'll rehearse a focus pull and keep experimenting until I get my start focus value, which is 0.6, and then I'll find my end focus value, which is about 0.8. Now I know I need to go from 0.6 to 0.8. I'll hit record, and it sort of gets the job done, but you'll notice how it is an instant jump with no smooth ramp, making for very ugly focus pulls. As a result, this is not an app I would ever use to adjust focus while recording. Exposure thankfully works a little better. Auto exposure does continue to function while recording, unlike focus. And for best results, you'll want to use manual exposure where you can control both shutter speed and ISO independently. And if you want cinematic motion blur using the 180 degree shutter rule, you'll absolutely need ND filters in daylight. I've linked the ones I recommend below. Unfortunately, exposure has one major issue, and this isn't srRAW's fault. iOS doesn't allow apps to access a true RAW live preview. This means that what you see on screen doesn't reflect the actual recorded image. And because srRAW doesn't provide histograms, zebras, false color, or any kind of clipping indicators that reference the RAW stream, you're basically flying blind. Currently, the best exposure method in srRAW is this. Expose by eye using the live preview. I tend to underexpose as I can restore shadows later in post. Record a short test clip. Tap the folder icon to open the files directory, and tap to open a DNG frame. Currently, a bug displays this in the wrong orientation, which is frustrating, but you can zoom in to check for blown out highlights. Then return to srRAW and adjust exposure as needed. Obviously, this is less than ideal, however, I will say that with some use of the app, you do get quite good at guessing off the preview how the finished shot will look, especially when you keep in mind that with RAW video, you have a huge amount of room in post to push and pull the image. And a last note on exposure, during capture, only ISO is adjustable, not shutter speed. As mentioned earlier, srRAW doesn't offer manual white balance. Instead, it operates automatically and will lock the white balance as soon as you hit record. To help with this, include a white balance card at the start of your shot, like this one from X-Rite or Calibrite, which is linked below. But remember, focus will also lock when you hit record, so the best sequence is use autofocus if appropriate to set your focus, then switch to manual focus to lock this value. Next, bring in your white balance card and fill the frame, then hit record and remove the card. Since this is RAW, you can easily change your white balance in post, but getting it close in camera will always be best. To review your recordings, tap the folder icon in srRAW to jump directly into the default directory in Files. Each clip gets its own folder, named by date and time, and inside you'll find a full DNG image sequence, a .wav audio file, and a proxy MOV file you can play back on your iPhone. Tap the proxy to quickly preview your recording. For an accurate preview of what you actually recorded, you'll need to open a DNG frame and inspect that. However, for full RAW video playback, you'll need to move the files to a computer, which we'll cover in just a moment. But before that, you might be wondering, given how massive RAW video files are, can srRAW record directly to an external SSD? Unfortunately, no. And according to the developers, this is a limitation of iOS, so don't expect support anytime soon. What you can do if your storage is full is manually offload recordings to an SSD to free up space on your device. Just connect your SSD to your iPhone, check the link in the description for the one I recommend, open the Files app, and under On My iPhone, select srRAW, then select the folders that you want to copy, tap Move, select your SSD, and tap Copy, then wait. This isn't a quick process due to the file size, but once complete, verify that the copy was successful, and you are now free to delete the files from your iPhone. Just remember, you also need to remove them from the recently deleted folder to actually free up space. Currently, you can't edit or grade RAW video on iOS, so you'll need a Mac or Windows PC. Most NLEs support Cinema DNG, but DaVinci Resolve is hands down the best, and it's free. Although upgrading to Resolve Studio unlocks noise reduction and the color space transform, both essential for more advanced RAW workflows. Here's the basic workflow. Connect your iPhone, go to Files, srRAW, and then copy your folders across to your computer. Open DaVinci Resolve and go to the Media page. Import your folders. Each clip will appear as a single playable video file. Switch to the Edit page, select your clips, then right-click on them and choose Create New Timeline. Jump to the Color page. Select a clip. It may look underexposed, but that's okay. Open Camera Raw, change decode using from Project to Clip, and now you can adjust exposure, highlight recovery, shadows, contrast, and white balance, and even sharpening. And this is where RAW video shines, full control with no baked-in look. If you have Resolve Studio, there is a more advanced workflow I like to use. I start by setting my clip color space to P3D60 and gamma to linear. Then I use a color space transform to convert to Rec 2020 and Apple Log, as this lets me use the epic LUTs I created for Apple Log with srRAW footage. Once the LUTs applied, you might want to make some minor tweaks in the camera RAW settings to your exposure. If you've got LUTs for Sony or Canon Log formats, you can do the same thing. Just choose the color space and gamma the LUT was designed for, and you'll be good to go. And you'll probably want to add noise reduction, especially for low light shots. Just add it at the very beginning of your node tree, and this is another studio only feature. Let's compare the before and after, and you can see why, once you start working with RAW, it's very hard to go back to compressed HEVC or even ProRes. So now you know how to use srRAW for iPhone to capture and process RAW video. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like and a share, it helps a lot. And if you want to continue to explore mobile filmmaking on both iPhone and Android, please subscribe to the channel and click the bell notification. In future videos, I plan on doing deep dives on RAW vs Apple Log on the iPhone, as well as srRAW vs Motion Cam Pro on Android. Any questions or thoughts, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.